Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will demonstrate how to group editors in the .NET MAUI DataForm control. The DataForm is used to create or edit data forms such as sign-in, sign-up, registration, payment forms, and more based on the business purpose. I'll show you how to customize the order of the editors within a group, group name, and layout. I will also show how to restrict the expansion and collapse action of the group, hide a specific group of editors in a view, and customize the appearance of the group headers. I am using an existing MAUI application where I've already configured the necessary DataForm namespace and added the MAUI DataForm control. In this working example, I've bound the model class to collect contact information, including the user's first name, middle name, last name, and more. I've also generated one contact details in the view model class. If you want to learn how to add the data form to an app, I recommend watching the Getting Started video linked to the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. Now, I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the data form is displayed to collect contact details. Next, I will demonstrate how to group editors using events. For example, I will group the first name, middle name, and last name into the name group. To achieve this, wire up the Generate DataForm Item event, which is triggered during the creation of DataForm items. Navigate to the Event Handler method. Here, check if the DataForm item from the event arguments is not null. If it is, then verify if the DataForm item's field name is first name, last name, or middle name. If any of these conditions are met, set the group name to name. As a result, you can see that the first name, last name, and middle name editors are now displayed under the name group. Next, I will demonstrate how to group editors using display attribute. Similar to grouping using events, I will group the mobile number, landline number, email, and address under the name details. I navigate to the model class. In the display attribute of mobile number, set the group name to details, and repeat this step for the landline number, email, and address properties. Now, you can observe that the details group has been created. Next, let me demonstrate how to change the order of the editors within a group using events. As an example, I rearrange the name group to display first, middle, and last names. To achieve this, go to the main CS page and inside the event handler for the Generate DataForm Item event. Check if the field name is middle name. If it is, set the row order to 1. Similarly, adjust the order for the last name fields. As you can see, the order of editors in the name group has been customized. Next, I will show you how to customize the order in the details group using attributes. I navigate to the model class, set the display attribute order to 1 for the mobile number property, and then set the order for the landline number, email, and address properties. Look here, the details group editor's order is customized. To customize the details group name, check if the data form item group name is details. If it is, set the group name to contact details. Now, see that the group name has been changed to contact details. Next, I will show you how to customize the layout. Before I start, remove the code changes related to customizing the order of the group editors and customizing the group name. For example, I want to position all the editors horizontally in the name group. To do this, in the event handler method, first check if the DataForm group item is not null. If it is, then verify that DataForm group item name is name. If it is, set the column count to 3. Next, arrange the two editors in a row within the details group. So, check DataForm group item name is details. And if it is, set the column count to 2. Then, navigate to the main page to position the label at the top. So, create an instance of the DataForm default layout settings element and assign it to the default layout settings property. And set the label position to top. Now, observe that the layout of the two groups has been customized and the label is positioned at the top. To initially collapse the name group, remove the column count property to show the editor in the default layout and set the isExpanded property to false. Here, you can see that the name group was in a collapsed state initially, and when I tap the group, it expands. Next, I will demonstrate how to restrict the expanding and collapsing actions for specific groups. To disable expand and collapse for the details group, set the allow expand collapse property to false. You'll notice that the details group will be expanded and cannot be collapsed, while the name group will continue to expand and collapse as usual. Now, let me demonstrate how to hide a specific group from the view. For example, if you wish to hide the name group from the view, remove the isExpanded property and set the isVisible property of the DataForm group item to false inside the name group condition. Looking here, the name group is no longer visible. Finally, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the group header. Before I start, remove the code changes related to restricting the expand and collapse action and hiding a group in a view. To modify the group header background of the name group, set the header background to the appropriate color. For customizing the header text, assign a new instance of DataForm text style to group item header text style. In this instance, set the font size to 16 and font attributes to bold. Now, you can observe that the group header background appears in different color and the font is bold. In this video, I have shown you how to group editors in the .NET MAUI DataForm control. I have also demonstrated how to customize the order of the editors within the group, customize the group name and layout, restrict the expansion and collapse of group editors, hide specific group editors in a view, and customize the appearance of the group headers. If you want to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.